Friday fun day is what I like to call Friday.
Yeah.
I don't know why our mics just got extraordinarily loud, but we're going to have to back off a little. Oh, thank you, Lord. We come into your presence with grateful hearts for all that you are and all that you've done. And we remember. We remember. We set our thoughts and our attentions on this time of coming to connect with you, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you.
You would take my place. You would bear my cross. You laid down your life that I would be set free. Oh, Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me. Thank you, Lord, all that you've done. Thank you, Lord, all that you've done for me.
So I appreciate you holding my family up in prayers, my other grandparent. My dad's mom went to be with Jesus right after worship yesterday. So it's my mom lost her dad and my dad lost his mom all within about a little over 30 hours of each other. So they were racing to the kingdom. Right, they're not, and they're champions of heaven. And I'm telling you, the Lord has been ministering to me specifically with songs that talk about defeating the grave, just conquering the grave. And so I thank you guys for your prayers, and that's why they're not able to be here this morning. My dad's, thankfully, some of his brothers and sisters that were spread out all across the nation, even in Alaska, are here now and got to be here. And one of his brothers was literally in the air when she passed away on a plane getting ready to land in Portland. So all his family are together, and God's just loving on us and pouring out on us in this season. But I just really, my dad talks about this a lot as there's, you know, we get older on in life, and my dad's done quite a few memorial services. We like to call them celebrations of life. For those who are in Christ Jesus have come into life. Amen?
Yeah.
Amen. Life everlasting. And so, you know, Jesus, when Lazarus had passed away, his buddy, Jesus was trying to teach the disciples and those closest to him a valuable lesson about the power that he holds. And I heard a sermon a couple years ago about that scripture where it says Jesus wept in John. And the man Jesus was grieving the loss of his friend. And at the same time, the Son of God, Jesus, was having to hold back and wait and let this become more of an impossible situation, so that he could display his power in a new way to his disciples and those who were following him. They'd seen miracles, they'd seen great things, but they had not seen the dead come back to life yet. And Jesus wanted them to grasp an understanding of, this is the type of power that I hold. And you need to understand that the power of the kingdom is so much greater than anything on this earth. And so he was trying to instill in them this principle about how much power the kingdom of heaven has. So as he was grieving as a man, having to wait, I'm sure as a man he was like, man, I just want to go raise him from the dead right now. Like right now. So he gets there and everyone's up in arms. And they're, oh, if you'd have been here, we've seen you heal. If you'd have been here, he wouldn't be dead. If you'd have been here. See, they knew that Jesus could heal. They knew that Jesus could step into that situation, but they hadn't seen Jesus deal with death on that level yet. So Jesus says, it's okay. He's just sleeping. And they're like, no. He's in a grave, wrapped up in burial stuff, and we're pretty sure he's starting to stink. So, yeah, you're a little off, Jesus. But Jesus called Lazarus forth from the grave, and he was resurrected. And all of those that witnessed got to experience the power of defeating the grave. And that's what Jesus came to rip out of the hands of the enemy. It's where the enemy no longer has. The enemy's been defeated, and death is no longer his victory. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. So, they've just just moved on into life, and we get to declare the victory over the grave. We get to declare life everlasting. We get to declare over our lives. And it doesn't mean that we don't grieve, guys. This is not, my heart is sad. I have cried more tears than I thought I even had in my body. I didn't, times when I think, man, okay, I'm done. I haven't been able to cry. There's no way. And then a flood will just hit me, and it just, another wave of just sorrow and grieving and sadness of them not being here. But, so I'm not saying that. Grieving is an important part of experiencing loss. And Jesus grieved himself. And so, but that's not the end of the story. Amen?
Amen.
Jesus didn't die on the cross and stay in the ground, right? He was resurrected on the third day. And that's the good news of the gospel. That we serve a God who is greater, has a greater power than anything else on this earth. Amen?
Yes.
Amen. So Lord, we want to thank you for displaying that. We want to thank you for the ways that you have taken us into challenging situations. Have you ever asked, thanked God for giving you a challenging situation?
Yeah.
Don't think about that. There's a lot of people that, it's always, God, take this away. Thank you, God, for putting us in challenging situations that make us exercise our faith.
Yes,
and
God.
cause our belief system to have to shift in a new way and go deeper with the revelation of who you are and the power that you have and the love that you have for us. So thank you, Lord, for those opportunities for our faith to grow and for us to get a greater understanding of who you are.
You.
Thank you. Your splendor, all your majesty does change.
How do I say thank you, Lord, for the life, for the life that you gave, Jesus, and my cross that you bore.
Can run it. Oh, Lord.
His grace unfold. You can run Him. You can run Him. Lord, you can. Lord, you can. Thank you.
your Holy Spirit's saying right now. Some of you just need to be reminded of who God is right now in this moment. You just need to know. Just be reminded about who He is. So we're going to sing verse 2 again. Because you are strong. And you are sure. Because you are alive. And you endure. You are.
Thank you. All right.